Hi, in this session we are about to learn how to design barcode labels both for barcode printers as well as laser printers. So we can use Max ERP software and get barcode printed on dedicated barcode printers, as well as we can even get A4 sheet sticker sheets and get the barcode printed on A4 sticker sheets also using a laser printer. Now how do we configure both of this? First let's understand on configuring barcode printing using a barcode printer. To do this, we will have to design a sticker first, and we use a software, a generic software used as Bartender. There are multiple designer software available as per the printer brands, but most commonly uses this Bartender software. Herein we can just create a new document. Generally barcode sticker size would be of 4 inches wide. That would be the sheet width. So there are generic sticker sizes available. 3 stickers, 2 stickers. So assuming, let's say we are taking this one. First thing that we do is we are designing a single sticker. So this one sticker design area we have in front of us, wherein we can just type any text, the single line object saying, let's say, I'll just take a simple example, let's say Max company name. We are designing the sticker as per the general information. Ensure that while designing this PRN, we have sufficient amount of space left on all the 4 sides. In case if there is any alignment issue, we have to make sure that the sticker content doesn't cross the other sticker or doesn't move down, and everything remains within the space of the sticker design. So we should have sufficient amount of space on all the four directions, sufficient amount of margins. So I'm just keeping everything aligned near the center. And the content, we have to design everything related to the sticker output that we are looking for. For example, company name would be required. We can even rotate the company name if required. Let's say for Max Enterprises, if we just want Max EME. So we can even do this where we can rotate this on the left hand side and keep this here. And there are even options where we can use this thing, where formatting options are available, where the content, it will be showing in black, the background will be black, and the content will be in white. Let's say draw a few of other couple other fields that are required. For example, I don't want this now. That's a product name. Get the barcode lines there. Barcode format that we are going to use is code 128 or code 39. That is the general formats that we are using. These days even QR code has also started coming, so even that can be used. For now I'm just selecting this one and I'm just dragging it here. So I need little more space so I can reduce the size of this. You can even have an alphanumeric content where in the data I can just define, let's say all my barcode should start from ME. So in the data sources I can just give ME. Here we have to make sure that the sticker lines should be, or we should have sufficient amount of space on the right hand side, because tomorrow if there's one letter increase in the barcode numbers, then it should not go beyond to the next sticker. To avoid this, we can even reduce this size so we have sufficient amount of space on this. Anyway, I have given the good length only, where it's 8 numbers along with 2 alphabets. So even in case if it's required more than this, then ensure that you have sufficient amount of space on for the lines, for the barcode lines, even if the caption is extended. The fonts that we generally use in the barcode printer should be the printer fonts, not the Arial fonts. There will be generic printer fonts available along with the printer drivers. I think in this system we do not have the printer drivers installed, so those printer fonts would not be coming by default. But otherwise you'll find printer font 1, printer font extended, printer font size. And we have to use using those fonts only we'll be able to get the PRN generated correctly. Otherwise you'll find some junk characters coming in the PRN. And then that might require some font downloading, font adjustment options available in the printer drivers. Post this I can just have a couple of other fields like, let's say MRP. So this is the caption which I have given and remaining is the value which I am defining here. So this is, let's say if MRP I want in bigger fonts or bolder fonts, I can have this way. So understood? Whatever contents we require, we have this play area for us where whatever we want we can design in that font and that size, however this is the output required. First thing we have to make sure is, after taking this, after designing this printing sticker, we have to freeze on the design part. There should not be any changes on the design part again, because if there are changes, again the entire export conversion to PR and then in linking to max, everything has to be redone again. The first thing that we do for the clients is ensure that the PRN file, the design output is as expected. Then no changes on the font, no changes on the sizes, nothing. Let's design how many ever times required here, do sample printing, get a confirmation, and then we will generate it to PRN and then link with max ERP. Okay. The two things we have to take care is getting confirmation of the final output design and ensuring that you have sufficient amount of space on all the four sides so that the sticker has sufficient margins. While designing the barcode stickers, make sure you design the correct layout. For example, if you have two stickers row, then each would be of 2 inches wide. Each sticker will be wide of 2 inches and height might be 1 or 2. So as per the sticker size, ensure you define the sticker label size correctly. All these are available in the label setup here, where you can select the paper size and then you can select the layout, number of rows and number of columns in a single sheet. Since the barcode printer is not installed here, it is showing A4 size paper. Otherwise, you will have only 4 inches play area. In label, we can even define by number of columns, number of rows, and the height and width of each and individual sticker also. Once the sticker is designed, we are saving this file in the Max ERP layouts folder for our future reference. So we'll just select the drive / Max ERP / layouts. And we'll give a sticker name saying the generic name. So your stickers there can be other information also, product code, vendor code, vendor name, date of purchase, maybe year of purchase, encrypted cost rate, encrypted sales rate, and there are a lot of informations which we can map on a barcode sticker. But then that part we will understand on the further, next session, in the upcoming part of the session. But in the sticker design, you can map whatever fields are required. In case if you have multiple fields to be displayed in a single row, you can even design in such a way where, for example, you need the supplier details here. And you can just give a simple code saying vendor or supplier code. Then / you can have month / invoice date / INB numbered / year. See, I can give multiple fields here. See, for us it's just a design and a text output here, and I can even shrink all this so that it comes within our area. Let's say I want this additional 5 inputs on the sticker with a smaller size. So this information also would be coming as a part of the output PRN file. So after saving this, how do we generate a PRN? So we have to click print here. In the print, we have an option saying print to file. Okay. When we select print to file, number of copies should be the number of stickers. See, by default it's showing one, but we have three stickers in a row as per this demo design. If there are two stickers, you have to select two. If it's one only, you have to select one. Since it's a three, we have to select three and click print. So it is saying where do we generate this output. So this output also should be in the max folder only. Under max ERP, we are keeping all this design part on the single folder. And it is generating a PRN. If you can see the extension, output.prn, I'll just change it to three stickers.pr. And what happens at the end, here three sticker PRN gets generated. It might not open directly, so you might have to select open with notepad and click OK. Now you are seeing junk characters coming here. Why you are seeing junk characters? Because we have not used the printer fonts. Okay. We will have to use printer fonts, or there are certain settings through which we can download this Arial font and the other two type fonts available in the system in the printer driver so that the output could come correctly. I'll just take a sample printout. So we'll see other PRNs that we have available in our layouts folder. So there are multiple other PRN, like let's say Raja 3 stickers. And you find output like this where you have a product name coming in. Product name 1, product name 2, product name 3. See, these are the final as per our output, it will just be product name, product name, product name. 99999, it will be that way. The first output would be as per the fields that we have created. So once the PRN is generated, we will open the PRN here in a notepad. You will find multiple lines coming here, and whatever is the output that we have designed in the sticker will be available here. I have taken a sample PRN which is having two stickers. So whatever fields that we gave, company name 1, it's coming once and it's coming twice. Then barcode is also coming twice. Then you are getting the product name coming here and all the other details are coming here. How do we map this in the software now? So once you come to Max ERP and you go to, let's say, see, barcode can be printed from product master also if it's product based barcode. What do you mean by product based barcode? Product itself will have a product code which will be the identifying key for this particular product, a unique code at the product master level. In case of a textile store or some other supermarkets, if the product is having auto tracking, then the product will be identified by the unique code which is generated while the purchase entry. So you can just give print barcode here, and you can select a particular product name for which you want the barcode to be printed, or else for us, we just need the barcode field list now. For once we select this barcode field list, we get all the fields that are available for our barcode printing. Okay. So we want first thing is the company name. So we just select this company name 1. What do you mean by company name 1? We have up to 10 fields option available, where the first field would be company name 1 and the second field would be company name. So you have to ensure that you do not do any mistakes in quotes and all. The second is company name 2. Same way for barcode, we have multiple options for barcode. We even term it as batch number. We term it as barcode number, we term it as batch name. All three are having the same output. If it's product master level, then it will be product code. Then product code extra 11, extra 22. This is also applicable. For product level, these are applicable. In case of a purchase with auto tracking, then the barcode numbers are applicable. So in our scenario, I'll just take this one, barcode number 1. Barcode number 2. Why we have kept multiple options? Sometimes you might have barcode number as a separate field and the text that comes in the below the barcode lines, same the barcode barcode lines are the encrypted part of those text. So that might be available as a other line. So that where we'll have to use barcode number 1 for the barcode field, and for the text below the barcode number we'll have to use as batch number or barcode name or batch name other field. Then we come with product name. Product name 1. Product name 2. And so even having a brand name, so I just select brand. Brand 1 and brand 2. MRP we have 999, so we will just change it to sales rate. We have sales rate. So if we have up to 10 stickers also, you'll have to change it as sales rate 1, sales rate 2, sales rate 3, sales rate 4. Able to follow? And then in the single field we have multiple parameters. So supplier code, we'll have supplier alias. This is the supplier master product. See, some client might require that supplier code to be coming on the sticker. So here we are getting supplier alias 1 and supplier alias 2. Then we have month. So you can even have encrypted month or direct month also is possible. Month, day, let's say a direct month of purchase is required. I can just select month, month 1, month 2. Why month 1 and 2? Clear? If there are 2 stickers, we are giving 2. If it's 3, means everything will repeat itself thrice in this single output. So where we'll use 1 and 2 and 3. Then invoice date. Number. And finally we have year. See, year can be in 4 digits also, year can be in 2 digits also. Month can be in numbers also, it can be in alphabets also. The triple M means 3 alphabets. January, February, March. Jan, Feb, MAR will be like that. Here if someone says I need in 4, then we have to use this one option. Y. The output will come in 4, 2017. Otherwise it will just be 17. So this entire output will get automatically switched over, and in a single line itself you will find all these values getting linked automatically. We just save this file and we close this here. So I am just closing this bartender also. Clear with bartender? How do we design? Ensure you have sufficient margins on all the four sides, and make sure the design is freezed, test n number of times, get a final approval, and then only you generate to PRN. After PRN generation, we'll have to do all this field mapping and then link it with the software. To avoid this repetition of field mapping again and again, better freeze the design first so that we do not have any changes coming immediately or even in the near future. Ensure that you have sufficient amount. The near future means what changes would come in? Maximum the barcode lines, the numbers might increase. So ensure you have sufficient space there. And all this you have to save in the Max ERP layouts folder. Anything which is connected with barcode printer will be stored here. So we have this 3-sticker design as well as this 2-sticker design PRN. Out of this we have generated this PRN and we have mapped the field. Now what is the next part? Next part is linking it with the software. See, we are not getting any barcode profile or the print linked here. So we can have multiple sticker design in a single software. What do you mean by multiple sticker design? I might have small tags, I might have big tags, or I might have 2 sticker tags, 4 sticker tags. Certain products are small, so might require small stickers. For that I might have 4 stickers per row. Currently I have designed for 2 sticker per row. So we can have n number of designs linked in a single software, and we can choose which sticker design we want for the printing. While going for the barcode printing, we can select that profile. So how do we create that profile first? For creating the barcode profile, we have to go to barcode master. In barcode master, I am just selecting, let's say, 3 stickers, or we have just 2 stickers. Print using barcode printer or laser printer. Laser printer means you will require the Max Report Designer tool, and the barcode field should be in the reports folder. Otherwise, now for barcode printer, it will search for all PRN files available in the layouts folder. See, all PRN files of the layouts folder are coming here. So I just like this two sticker design. For these two stickers, this PRN will be used. What printer should be used? So you can select the respective printer for the output. Here, number of copies is 1, number of row is 1. In one row, you have 2 columns. This is one important part. Two stickers means you have 2 columns. If it's 3 stickers, you have to select 3. Okay. What else do we have apart from this? Product length. Product length in the sense, product name length. If the sticker seems to be small and the product name goes beyond, then you might require the product to be printed on multiple lines. We have those field options also, where in the barcode field list we have product name, line 1, line 2, line 3. Okay, so we can get the product name printed in 3 lines also maximum. In case if you want to split that, then how much would be the length for one line? You can give 10 characters or 15 characters. So up to 15 characters it will print in first line, then 16th one will be continued in the second line. Then we have multiple printing options available. So here we have generally just select direct printing only. There are multiple options available here. Just select direct printing. This is by default. And there's no LPT port here. In case if we are using the LPT port, then we'll have to give the port name also. So currently it's just direct printing, which generally works across all now. Then we have an option saying print new product in new line. What do you mean by that? If I'm printing, I'm taking a purchase of 100 products. Or let's say 10 different products, 100 quantity each, or 100 quantity altogether. First product might have 13 quantity, second might have 12 quantity. And if it's a two sticker design, when you say 13 quantity, 7 rows will get printed. Correct? The 7th row, only one sticker will be printed, the next sticker will be blank. Or it will continue the next product. Let's say serial number 1 has 13 quantity. 13 will get printed. And then on the 14th sticker, which is the 7th row as per this design, 14th sticker would be the second product which will get continued. In case if we don't want the next product to start immediately, then you have to take this. The 14th sticker will remain blank. 15th sticker onwards, the second product or the next serial number, once the product gets changed basically, it will leave that row blank and then we'll start with the next row. If it's exactly 14 quantity means, it's by default a new row only, no confusion at all. If it's only 13 stickers, then the 14th sticker will remain blank and then it will 15 sticker onwards, it will take the next product printing. So user has clarity that one sticker blank means this product has got over and the next sticker gets in use. These are all useful options in supermarkets and textile stores. What do you mean by this blank fields? Blank fields is an option available for ensuring that the last sticker comes blank. By default, the output of the last sticker would be as per the PRN file. When we have this, if it's the last sticker means, you'll get this output as company name 2, barcode number 2, product name 2. See, these are internal fields which will automatically get blank. But this caption MRP sales rupees, this caption will not get blank on its own. This slash will not get blanks on their own. The slash will remain in between. Because only the fields are getting changed. The external captions are not getting removed on the last sticker. So when you see the last sticker, you'll only have those captions MRP colon rupees dot, but no value. Barcode lines will not be there, product name will not be there. Any other text captions that you have given would be there, the slash would be there. Okay. So to avoid this, in the last sticker, we can just give comma separate value saying all the blanks for the last sticker should be removed, should be replaced. Same way MRP and this rupees caption for the last sticker also should be replaced. So you can just give comma separated values here. So it will automatically find the last sticker and replace all these values, comma separated values which are available in that design. What is the purpose? The final sticker will remain completely blank, not even any captions coming on it. Otherwise sometimes user gets confused saying the output has not come, or the printer has, the software has not printed correctly. There are 13 stickers only, but the 14th one comes with a blank, just the captions and no values. Then the user might get confused there. So to avoid this, we have this option where you can give all the blank field captions here, and the software fields are by default getting nullified. This comma separated values here also will be removed from the last sticker only. Clear? I can have one more option saying, let's say 4 stickers, and I can have multiple outputs here. Let's say Raja 4 stickers. I can select some other printer. See, we can have different printers for different stickers. I might have a dedicated printer for 4 print stickers separately, 2 stickers separately. So I can select that particular printer here and it will automatically map here. And 4 stickers, the column will have to be 4, and you can just save this. You can even give a test print out from here itself. You can select a test print from here. You can even call the barcode field list from here. So you have this product name line 1, 1, line 2, 1, line 3, 1. If it's multiple stickers means, then it will be line 1, 2, line 2, 2, line 3, 2. If 4 stickers means line 1, 3, line 2, 3, line 3, 3. Okay. Able to follow this mapping concept? Okay. We'll even create a link for a laser printer also. Let's say 4 stickers laser printer. Here I'll just select laser printer and I select printer print file name. So this print file is coming from the reports folder. Barcode A4, I mean barcode 4x12 desired. This is A4 based printing, A4 size, and it's coming from a laser printer. For the laser printer, it will come from the reports folder. How do you design that? So in the reports folder, we have an option in Crystal Report through which we can design the output for the. So this is a free font that we are using, free 3 of 9 extended. This font has to be there in the customer system. If it's multi-user, then all the client system also should have this font. This font has to be copied to the CDrive Windows fonts folder, then only will get listed here. And once it is listed, then only the barcode printing will come in the output. For the barcode printing to come in the output, there are two things here. We have to use a star initially. First alphabet is star, and then the field. For you to understand it better, I'll just change the font for once. And select some other font. So the output is star, then the field name, batch number, and a star. Okay. When we have the star and the field name and then star, then only the barcode printing will come correctly, otherwise it won't come. Using this free font specifically. Okay. When we're using this font, it has a standard through which it works. So all the output should be starting, prefix and suffix should be star, and then the field name in between. Rest the barcode number is again here, batch serial number, and the sales data are coming here. How do we design this? See, in Crystal Board we are designing only 1 sticker, remaining 2 are coming automatically. So this is not a 4 sticker design layout, it is actually a 3 sticker design layout only. The file name is saying 4x12, whereas it's 3x12. We are just designing this output, remaining all changes automatically. See, I just remove something, if I change something here, if I make it bold, it will get bold in all the stickers also. The other ones will work automatically. Once I save. We have this in the section expert where you have option for layout, where you can define the sticker size. Each sticker size can be defined, width and height, any vertical horizontal gap. So in this, as per this design, you're getting 3 stickers across and 8 downwards, which is 24 stickers in a row. This is a standard sticker size available in the A4 paper. And all the fields for the barcode are available here. The same fields which we had there are also available here also. Here we need not have 1, 2 and 3 because in Crystal Report it will repeat itself on its own. Every output is one, I mean a direct design. If you have multiple barcode numbers or multiple company name, you can just keep one company name here, one company name on the other side, and it will get the output printed. The fields are directly being mapped. Whereas in the barcode, by using a PRN, we are replacing the content of a notepad file, the PRN file. How many times should be replaced accordingly for replacing, we have that 1, 2, 3, 4 captions coming along. Okay, I'm just closing with this. I can select a separate printer for the crystal report also, and I have to mention the number of columns, saying 3. So this is 3 stickers basically, not 4. I just save this. Clear with the crystal report part and barcode designing, PRN and integration. Apart from this, we have an additional option here saying barcode generator. What does this option mean? Barcode generator, you find search and as a default value saying ASON 01010001, prefix is MA and length is 5, current seed going on is 53. So now I can have this numbers reset every month. For example, from first, let's say from 1st January onwards, I want new numbers. So I can have saying Jan 18. I can just mention a date saying 1/1/18. Prefix should be MA, suffix can be anything. Seed should be 5, the starting number should be 1000, seed can be 4. So from 1st January onwards, the output of the barcode numbers that gets generated from the purchase for auto tracking products, it will be like MA 1001, 1002, 1003, it will start from there. Likewise, I can change the sequence every month. Instead of having barcode numbers going in lakhs, we can reset it every month with a different prefix. This is not for laser or barcode, this is directly from the purchase. While you do a purchase entry and we save and it generates the barcode numbers, based on this prefix only it generates the barcodes. This prefix and suffix, whatever defined here, that will be the barcode lines content. And you see the output of the sticker, the barcode lines and the code that comes below would be based on this. Okay, so by default it starts as length of 5 and it will start from number 1. So basically MA00001, that is how it starts from. And now it's, we can reset this on it as per different dates for the different months. This can even be distincted location wise. If I have two branches, one branch will start as B 1001 1002 1003, for other branch it can be C 1001 1002 1003. So I can quickly identify seeing the barcode sticker itself from which branch it has been generated. Alternatively, it can even be for multiple companies. In case if I have multiple companies in a single book, like Max Enterprises, Max Traders, Max Textiles, Max Supermarket, so for multiple companies I can select which company, what should be the prefix. So anything which is coming inwards from Max Enterprises should have ME. Anything which comes from Max Supermarket should have MS. Anything coming from Max Traders should be MT, MT 1001 1002. So once we have multiple companies and multiple locations configured, you will even have that option coming at the top in the same screen, where you have to select the company and the location first and what is the prefix defined for that particular location. What is the advantage here? When this location branch people, if they are entering their purchase on their own, they'll have their branch based unique barcodes generated. Head office barcodes will be separate sequence, branch barcodes will go in a separate sequence. And the barcode, seeing the sticker itself, if there's any stock transfer that has happened, seeing the sticker you can quickly identify which company or which branch that sticker belongs to or from where it has been originated. Okay. So likewise, the barcode numbers can be set for location or company, as well as if it's a direct barcode also, you can define it for multiple months. Every month you can reset it from number 1 rather than going in continuously on lakhs and thousands. Now from where all we can print barcode, see there is even an option through which we can print the barcodes in a challan. In retail outlets, if you require the barcode to be coming at the bottom for that particular voucher number or for any particular field also, you can map it in the printout. How do we map this? Using that free font itself. Free font should be installed on the system, maybe it should be in the copied in the Windows fonts folder, and then we can map it at the bottom of the printer. or print design. As like laser printer, we need that print font. Again, in this normal output also, any design we can just link this, and the output will have the barcode lines coming here. So this can be quickly scanned and we can quickly find out the particular voucher. So in case if the customer comes for a return, you can just scan that barcode and you can quickly find out which transaction it is. That is also an advantage with the free fonts. We can map this free fonts in the any report format also, not only on the laser stickers, I mean laser printer based barcode stickers, we can even link it in the output of the print formats. Now from where all we can get the barcode printed? In case if it's a general product, let's say I take, see all the inward vouchers like purchase, stock journal, stock inward, production module through which the stocks are getting converted. So if the product is of auto tracking type or it is having a product code, then it will come for the barcode printing. Okay, so let's say I just give you a sample. Let's say Deepak Traders. Now classmate book, I just give 10 pieces and I just save this. So it automatically generates 10 stickers, whereas this is a general product only. The code is coming from the product master code P1003. So if I have a set of general products also which are directly linked from product master level, even for those I can get the barcode printed. And while printing this barcode, I am getting all these options now: 2 stickers, 4 stickers, 3 sticker laser printer, along with the print file name. So if I select this one, automatically the laser printer whichever I have routed that will come and you can directly click print. It might generate a preview for this. So while giving in a laser printer, it is asking what is the starting label number, count across and then downwards. What is the advantage here? Label laser stickers will have 24 rows and we cannot scroll anything. There's no option of scrolling. To let's say out of 24 we have just printed 12 stickers, so half of the sheet is done. Remaining half, instead of going it waste, we can just give the starting number as 13, and when we can click proceed here. So it will show you a preview. When you see the preview, see the upper part is coming blank, but laser printing will start from the bottom. So 3, 3, 3, 3, 4 rows, 12 are done. From the 13th sticker, it is coming print out. So even in case you peel out all the first 12 and you can stick, instead of going the stickers waste, you can start from the 13th sticker. From 13, 3, 3, 3, 9, and the 10th one has come. And the last 2 stickers are still blank. For the next printing, you can just give 20th, out of 24, you can give 23, and the printing will start from here, from this blank position. This is 22nd, 23 will start from here. And if it's a normal barcode printer, you just select this and click print. You can even download the PRN file here, save to PRN. What do you mean by save to PRN? The entire content of this would get saved in a separate output file which can be printed using, we have a separate tool through which we can directly generate the output in the PRN and get it printed. In case if the printer is not physically attached with the system, the barcode printer, then you can save a PRN file, use that Max barcode printing tool and select this PRN file and the print, move it to the system where the printer is connected and you can print from there. But for now you can directly click print here and it will start printing in a, the output will be directly printed, get printed here. So you can automatically see the company name has been replaced, Max Enterprises, the product code has come, the product name has come, product brand has come. MRP was mentioned 0, the sales rate has not been defined here, so it's coming as 0. Then you are getting the supplier code S002, the day, then the month of purchase 12. Then you have the date of invoice date, and then you have invoice number, and then you have year. What mistake we have done here? Invoice month and invoice date, and whatever field that we have mapped here, all have come, but month and year, we have given the date also, as well as we have given month and year also. So this output will get printed in here. Stickers. Since it's 2 stickers, it's getting 2. So one sample output has come. Likewise, there will be multiple files which gets generated at the back end. For 10 stickers, it will generate 5 files and it will push automatically to the printer. These files will be generated in the Max temp folder. Where do you see this? You can just go to home, select the Max ERP folder. Under this, you can give to go to the temp folder and you can see those barcode files. So you see the 5 files getting generated here. this is, I mean, two stickers each, 2, 2, 2, 2, likewise. The one way is directly from product master also, we can just select a particular product, classmate, and we can get the barcode printed from here. So this product is selected, how many stickers do you want? You can select 5 stickers, and you can select, let's say, the other product also, let's say P1002. How many stickers? Let's say 5 stickers of this. So Parker Z pen also come. So you can append as many barcode stickers that you want, select the number of stickers that you want here, and directly click append. So all these products will automatically append next to each other, and as per the barcode profile, barcode name design profile that you have selected, it will print out. Whether it's a laser printer or dot matrix printer with all the configurations that we have done in the barcode master. So you can select any number of products here. So one option is to get barcode printed from product master. Second is from the purchase itself. Third is stock invert. In case if we are having a job work module, so while issuing we might issue a material, while receiving we might receive the end product like shirts. And while receiving from job work invert, that also it will generate unique barcodes for the products for shirts. And it can even be used in stock journal where we have something in the output and something else in the invert, it will generate the barcodes for the invert if the product has the barcode integrated. Similarly, in the production module also we have this barcode printing. For example, we have given let's say sugar, ghee, and let's say flour for a cake. The output one product that will come would be cakes. So if we are given n number of raw material and the 10 cakes are coming in, 10 stickers will get generated. So we can keep them in the rack. Along with that, we can even have this packing date, expiry date for all those products stickered, I mean on the printed on the sticker while production module. Even in this normal purchase also, if the product has the expiry and manufacturing date, then it will ask for those information, and even that can be mapped on the barcode printing. We will see a textile store options that we have seen other, let's say sarees and material. Here once we give print barcode, these numbers are coming here. MA00001415. This is what we seen in the barcode generator. This number can be reset every month basis, it can be company wise, it can be location wise. So it is generating unique numbers for each and every product here. So this again can be printed with all this information of style, pattern, design, color, all this can be mapped in the sticker along with the encrypted cost rate. What is encrypted cost rate? We had this option of number encryption in our master. So we have given certain code saying Tendulkar's, 0 means T, 1 means E. Whatever is the cost of the product, see the cost that is saying DLT.TT. DLT means as per the code, D is for 3, L is 5, and T. So the product cost is 350. Only the owners will know what is the exact cost, so they can have the convenient bargain done on the product and they can decide whether to be sold or not to sold. So certain small scale stores or medium SMEs stores will have this cost rate printed on the barcode stickers, so they can quickly come to a judgment. You can get all the information of the masters and the invoice including the serial number of the product. See entry serial number, it says 11111. And it says 2 and then 3. For 3 there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So all this serial number to identify on which purchase, what was the product serial number that is getting printed, serial number 1, 2 or 3. We can quickly identify which purchase and what serial number it was that particular product belongs to. And quickly we can even refer that as well as we can use it for purchase return. All the matrix information, master information, and the transaction information can be printed here. In the barcode printing screen, we even have an option to attach the images. We can attach an image using a webcam, you can use a scanner for attaching an image for the particular product, or you can just browse and select the product image. The same is possible with the product master also, where you can just select an image for a product. This is with individual barcode. Individual barcode, you can select a unique image. So this is all with the barcode part. We can use both barcode printer as well as laser printers, and for laser printer we'll have to use this font 3 of 9. I mean font 3 3 of 9. That font has to be there in the Windows fonts folder, then only we can use it. And for using that font, we have to make sure we have to use a star and then the field name and then a star. So we have to actually map a text field, type a star, then drag and drop the field of the barcode output, and then again suffix it with another star. Then only we get printed correctly. And for barcode printers, ensure that you design the stickers correctly with sufficient amount of margin on all 4 sides. And design it perfectly once. After confirmation, you generate a PR and then link with the software. You can have multiple barcode stickers here and you can choose which design you want to be printed. So if it's a small sticker, you can just select particular barcode, let's say you can just select a few ones from this. And you can select for this 3, you need a small sticker, means you can select the 4 sticker model and you can print. If it's a bigger tag, means you can select the bigger tag format, 2 stickers. If it's a laser printer, you can select that particular format. So you can have multiple barcode designs also, and you can have this barcode generation to be reset monthly basis. And you can get barcode printed right from Product Master as well as from all the inwards. There is an alternate way through which we can record or we can generate PRN files from the designer if a direct printout option is not available. Standard option is once we click print and we give this print to file option and give the number of stickers that are linked with that particular design and click a print. So this will generate in PRN automatically. The second way of generating PRN is you have to go to the printer properties. In case if this print option is not enabled or it's not available, then you have to go to the printer properties and you have to open the control panel, devices and printers under control panel, and you have to go to this printer properties. Go to the port and select this file option. The general option selected would be a USB port connection or a COM port, whatever it is, for printing the content to a PRN file. You have to select this in the port option saying print to file. Tick this, give an OK, and then once you give printout from the software, it will ask you for a print file generation on its own. So this will help you in printing or creating the PRN file through the printer port rather than from the designer software. After setting this print to file, you will again have to mark go to the printer properties and change the printer port to the standard one, whichever it is, if it's a USB or a normal port. Just ensure you change it back to the normal port so that the printer output gets printed correctly. Otherwise, it will every time it will, from the software also, once you give print of the barcodes, it will ask you to select the PRN file. So this print to file option can be used for generating PRN. Once this option is used and PRN is generated, you have to switch back to the regular port of the printer for the printing to come correctly. So that's all with barcode printing options with MaxERP. Thanks a lot.